Hey guys, hello and welcome back to some more Metal Gear Solid 4. How's everybody doing today? Happy Wednesday, happy hump day as the kids say nowadays. First and foremost, even though I said it already, Purge and Ragnar, thank you. Thank you so much for the hosts, both of you. Fantastic guys. Welcome back to some, oh, there you are. The Super Saiyan Toaster, which is fantastic. When equipped, allows you to intercept radio traffic from PMC Raven's sword. Causes the map screen to display areas where system members are currently located. I don't really know what that means, to tell you the truth. Look at that emote! It's fantastic! Hey, Strike! How you doing, Ragway? It is going well. So we got a bunch of...
First thing is to look for the resistance. Either use your radar to pick up their trail, or intercept the PMC's radio communications to learn where resistance members are most likely to be found.
Uh-huh. Cool. So, this is where we left off last time, and it's been like 2 weeks since we last played this game, which I'm sorry. It's just... That's just sort of the way that it turned out. South
the
Station.
Location of a resist-
we gotta announce the annual purge. How you doing, babe? I am doing well today. Nice. Who is this individual here?
You found a resistance member.
Okay, cool.
It's time to start tailing them. Get on it, Snake.
Tailing them, okay. Kill them all. Well, honestly, probably. Let's see how we do. As we all know all too well. Not the best when it comes to sneaking around, but maybe. Yeah, that doesn't help me in any way. Maybe. Just maybe. We can be a little better at tailing people. Raven Sword. That almost sounded like the person I was with. I don't know what is making all these noises. I'll be back to streaming and gaming April 2nd, so if you wanna do Nightfall sometime. Dude! That would be awesome! We could make it like a Sunday multiplayer collaboration. Stream, do a little bit of multiplayer Destiny, if you will. I think that could be a lot of fun. Put this shit away. I don't think we need it right now. Yes. Who is he tailing?
Those resistance fighters can't advance because of the PMC troops. Isn't there something you can do to help, Snake?
Really? You want me? Next Sunday. Well, yeah, I'm down for that. Well, we'll plan it out, buddy. We'll plan it out. Okay, well. Tell you what, then. Is that the only PMC? Don't look at me. Oh no, he's good. He's good. Ta-da. Actually, I enjoy the variety. I mean, it's always good to have something a little bit different along the way. Maybe some blubber. We'll see. We'll see what we can come up with. All right. So I'm assuming I'm gonna need to. Oh, never mind. This is a dead end. Okay. I thought maybe they would want me to kind of take a separate. adjacent path to his so that we can clear out the bodies. But you know, it's always good to throw in, you know, a couple different stages along the way. That's what's holding them up. Whoa, whoa, where are you going? Where are you going? Where'd he go? Take care of this guy. Where did he go though? Did we lose him? Ah, shit. Oh, wait, what? He's up there. What? How did you get up there? What's up with that? Me, you, Captain Wolf, playing Dark Souls 3 would be fun. Dude, that would be a lot of fun. That definitely would be. I don't think Cap has any Dark Souls, and honestly, like, I mean, I would have it on the or I'm planning to get it on the PS4 eventually, once hopefully all three of them come out. Oh shit, dude, I think we need to get up there. Hold on, maybe not. He might end up coming out here. Yeah, there he is. Okay. But dude, Strike, Bloodborne is fantastic. I do enjoy waiting, or not waiting, I started reading your comment there. But I do enjoy playing the hell out of that game anytime. It's, I put a lot of hours into that game for sure. Did he come down or did he? Oh, yep, there he is. Dark Souls Wandering Master. That would be, dude, I would be all over that. Dark Souls 3 without having played 1 and 2. That much though. No, I understand that, Purge. But I do see Ragnar's point. I'm the same way. There is no way that I will touch Dark Souls 3, or even 2 for that matter, without playing the previous one first. It's just it's a pseudo OCD thing. I can't do it. I can't do it. If I'm gonna play, before I pull out a gun, let me make sure that nobody's here. If I'm gonna play them. Which is honestly, at this point, is the only reason why I haven't played them yet. Come on. This guy keeps going wrong places. The reason why I haven't played them is because I haven't, you know, I plan on doing all of them, one after the other. It's just the way she goes. 2 and 3 already in PS4, yep. Leave it on PS4, and when that time comes, be ready. Be ready for some Dark Souls Kanan action. Those are statues, not soldiers. I'll help a Wonder Master. Well, I mean, we'll probably go through them alone first, because part of the appeal is, you know, the struggle, of course. Plus, I like to just sort of go through games like that on my own first to make sure. To make sure that I can do it first. To your own, you and I like to. I feel like a lot of people don't like to. I have heard that was the case. So you just took a piss in a public park. Pervert. Who am I tailing here? Don't jump over the wall. Oh, okay. Oh, I see. Oh, this is gonna be a little bit tougher. gotta do y'all one two punch here. There they go. Two worst the worst. I mean, I don't honestly know what, why people are of that opinion. Again, I'll be forming my own opinion once the time comes. Oh, nice. But I'm gonna suffer through it, and it'll be fine. Man, the game mechanics. Matching system for co-op was broken in two. Interesting, I don't know why we got bullets there out of nowhere. Man, this guy's going places. Okay. I think that means we have some PCMs, PMCs. Matchmaking 2 was level based and I hated it. Yeah, I can see how it would be very annoying. I do like the fact that that Bloodborne is password created for matchmaking at least. Because, yeah, to sit there and try to, like, do co-op, but you just basically have to wait and try to get lucky with who you get matched, that would be a real pain in the ass. Take quite a long time, I would imagine. The amazing flow to the game's world was completely absent from 2. Speaks the truth. I say, I'm sure. Sickens me, and I hated it. Well, don't worry about it. Hopefully, like, I don't know how long those games are meant to, supposed to be. I mean, I guess it sort of depends, right? Because on your skill level, because, like, I can get through Bloodborne in... Boy, hold on. I can get through Bloodborne, now that I'm familiar with the game, from start to end in probably, like, 4 hours. I don't know about this. But, like, my first playthrough of the game took me, you know, 40, so... That was tough, though. Depends on skill unlock. Yeah, no, that's pretty much it. Let's see what's, deals here. Oh, where'd the guy go? close. Seems to be going over to where this helicopter's at. That's a lot of PMCs, man. You want me to take them all out? Yeah, he's cool, he's cool. Get good. Look, I believe it.
Searchlight. Find something nearby to hide behind.
What does that mean? Where's the searchlight? I don't... Oh, the battery's dying! Oh, there's the searchlight, okay. God damn it, I don't want to miss this guy. Okay. A greater variety in character making. Being a mage is less fun. I mean, I think that's the one thing that I'm probably gonna be very basic when it comes to playing the game, is the fact that for Bloodborne, you know, you don't have to worry about, like, class-based character making, because it's just, you are what you are. Wait, are we supposed to help him?
Move along. Snake, find some way to free him.
Alright, hold on. I got this.
We're under attack!
sending reinforcements. Fuck. Use extra caution.
I really thought that that would work.
Wake up!
Here we go, they're out. Go, 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 go. Nice. Okay! Nobody! God damn it. That, I hope that didn't mess things up. Shit. Shit. It was all going so well. Or relatively well, at least. Oh, there he goes. Let him go. He's just booking it. Oh, hold up. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Let's go. Get that timer out of my face. Are we fine? I think we're fine. Okay. Fuck's sakes. Well, cat's out of the bag now. And I have no idea where this guy is. Shit.
This is HQ.
This is...
Acknowledge. Sending reinforcements.
Are we gonna have to murder everybody here? I'm not above it. Pyromancy is the way to start out. See, and like the thing is with games like that, you guys know I'm all about, you know, raw strength. So I'm probably gonna end up going with
Snake, find some way to free him.
Well, fuck it. Everybody is gonna die now. I tried.
We're under attack.
Ooh, wait, hold up. Do we have a suppressor on this thing? I think we do. That sounded like we did. Weapons. Custom. Yeah, we have a suppressor on it. A more tanky build? I mean... Yeah, ish. You're all gonna die. I'm done with it. I tried it the nice way.
This is HQ.
But yeah, we'll probably end up going with, you know, a bit of a tankier, like high strength, high vitality type build. That was basically my approach to Bloodborne. Right, it's just. I mean, you're not, you're gonna die, but you're fine. Whoa, hello. Did I do that? Shields work in Dark Souls. I'll back you up with magic, nice. Where's the flower thing? Put that on. Stress out. I just wish. Oh shit. I just wish I knew where this guy was. Oh, sir. That's a lot of health you just took out of me. I don't appreciate it, to say the least.
Snake, find some way to free him.
Yeah, dude, can you chill? You're gonna die or you'll be fine. We'll see.
Looks like you've lost track of your resistance target.
Yeah, a little
bit.
Don't
worry about it. You'll just have to start over and find a new one.
Ah, shit. Well, how do we do that? Alright, we're still trying to evade here. Oh, the body is gone. Let's put the gun away for now. You'll just have to start over, he says. But does that mean we need to walk all the way back? Or run all the way back? Oh, that's him right there!
Snake, he's about to be hauled off by the PMCs.
Yep. And I totally just messed that up. Always go two-handed. I'm sure I'll find my, my own ways to go about the world.
There's something wrong. Support you. Confirm their status.
Okay, he's coming our way.
What?
Oh! Hello! No, nobody. That was awesome. I mean, it wasn't. Oh, dude, Resi 5 is fantastic. I'm a huge fan of the entire Resi series.
Understood. The state of alert has been lifted. Resume positions.
Mind you, I've only played the quote-unquote mainstream series. So, I mean, like the direct sequences. Like I haven't played Code Veronica or any of the like the jail games and things like that. I'm just gonna follow this guy. I don't know if I'm okay doing that or not. Really nice. Yeah, see, I played through them all a while back. I mean, I had already I had already played through, like, 1 through 3 as a kid with my brothers and such. And then I started to step away from it just because, I don't know, I didn't have the consoles for it, basically. And I never owned a GameCube to play 4 through or a PS4. PS2. Oh, where are you going, buddy? But, yeah, so about 3, maybe 4 years ago, Elnaeus decided to make me play through the games again because he's a huge fan as well. And I was totally fine. I was down with it. Let's get you. Oh, hello. I was totally fine with it. I love the games, which is why I really push hard for Cap to play them when they're in the poll. Full compress. I don't know what that means. Can I get a suit as well?
There's something fishy about that PMC trooper.
Yeah, I understand.
Whistling?
Yes. Gensu assumes. Yeah, no, it would be a lot of fun too. And the problem, I mean, I wasn't a huge fan of 6. I'll tell you that right now. I mean, it was fun to play. The co-op aspect wasn't total garbage. Really don't have anything to regain our stamina with. Wait, are they mad at me or are they mad at him? They're mad at me. Shit. Run. I may need to take those PMCs out. Totally honest with you.
Don't scare me like that.
Yeah, I don't know where this guy's gonna end up at. Ah, shit, they're coming back to the post. Yeah, these guys are gonna have to go. Like, hard. Alright, well, sorry, bud.
The enemy's here! The enemy.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me! Shit, I did not know that would happen. I had no idea those were explosive things. Okay, well, this is the actual dude, bro. So let's just keep with him, I guess. Wait, who's shooting me? Yeah, this is garbage.
Understood.
Damn it.
Stand by. Sending reinforcements now.
I don't know why I did that. Again, this guy's bad. I don't want to kill the guy that we need. Is this him? Yeah, this is totally him. I know, because he sort of has the like bicycle helmet almost. Never play 7. Oh yeah, we played through 7. Not on stream, but like I have played the game on my own. Quite the game, I must say. I liked it. I liked it a lot. I'm very happy that they went back to being, you know, an actual horror game as opposed to a weird-ass action game. If you could even call it that. It was quite something else. Okay, that's the dude. Are there any actual PMCs around?
HQ, come in. This is HQ.
Okay. All clear.
Understood. The state of alert has been lifted. Resume positions.
Okay, I think we're all good to go. Sold Master Key. Holy shit, 9,000 Deverant points? Dude. I'm played 7, but a buddy of mine has PSVR. If I can convince him to let me borrow it, I'm going to buy 7. Dude, I would not have the stones to play 7 in VR. Oh shit. Is that him? Shit. I looked away for a second and now I don't know. I think that's him right on the left. Yeah, I think so. Cause he's not walking with a normal rifle. Basically. Yeah, no, I would not have it in me to play that game on VR. I'm a bit of a chicken shit, as some of you who were around for the 24-hour Halloween special last year would know by now. I scare very easily. Does that have a heart attack in VR? Yeah, I know. Hated how they made Chris in the DLC. I felt like he was not in the other game. Oh, is there already DLC for that game? I mean, I know that Chris did appear at the end of the game. Like made the cameo there. I had no idea that they actually already made some sort of DLC for that game. That's awesome if they did. Gotta get killed if you haven't saved. They make you start over at the beginning. Oh, you know what? That's a good idea. That's a good idea. Let's go ahead and save. I always forget to keep the saves going more often. I remember you seriously. Oh, I'm sure you'll see it. I mean, I'm probably gonna be doing another Halloween special this year as well. So, don't worry. We'll get there. There's a bunch of DLC. Oh, dude, I'm gonna definitely have to look into that then because I had no idea. So. I'm not completely oblivious to the fact that this guy is whistling in the same tune that what's her name, little girl, sings.
Looks like they're conducting vehicle patrols. Watch out for them, Snake.
Yeah, shit. I don't know if that's indicative of anything per se, but you know, just saying. And Chester passed her across. Remember your easily frightened. I'm sure you'll have fun with it, buddy. What? I didn't do anything! Recently. Dude, you need to bloody put the pedal to the metal here, buddy. You're taking way too long. I love scary people. Oh, great. You're gonna love the Halloween specials then, man. I have about... excuse me, guys. I have about 10 or 12 scary sound effects. Not active, of course. That basically were there to be used. Were there to be used if, like, throughout the stream, for you guys to just kind of fool around with me. And believe me, they were very well used. As soon as people found like their favorite ones, I was just done. I never stood a chance. I think we got up to one of the clips. Towards the end of the stream, actually the very end of the stream. Oh fuck! Can I get behind there? No, I can't. That's if that worked. One of the clips towards the end of the stream, there, you can see we got up to like 112 scares or something like that. Didn't really amount to anything. I was just giving away points every time, every 10 scares. We were giving away some points to everybody. It would be my imagination. But, yeah, it was a lot of fun. I did quite enjoy doing that stream. I mean, it was tough. It was my first ever 24-hour stream. Excuse me. It was my first ever, 24-hour stream, and it was successful, if I do say so myself. Permission to post clip? Absolutely, though. Absolutely, buddy. Let me go ahead and get the permit. Oh, I hate that. Puriofi. I hate that I can't do the at people on the bot. It's a little bit annoying. Okay, but let me go ahead. Is this the clip? That's me. All right, let me take a look here.
Damn, might be a fucking squeak. Oh, God.
What are you playing? A thief. Nice. Yeah, that sounds about right. I mean, the thing is, clipping wasn't a huge part of the channel back in the 24-hour stream. So I was a little sad because we did lose out on a lot of good scares throughout that stream. But again, I'm sure it will definitely not be the last time. Yeah, that's squeaky when I'm scared. I just try to laugh it off. I just try to laugh it off if I can. How was Thief, actually? I saw that game a while ago, because I think I own it on the Xbox One, because it was free for a while. Oh, wow, Snake. It was free for a while with Xbox Live.
Who's there?
But I never actually played it.
Here to see Big Mama.
Didn't finish it. Okay. What's it like though? Is it?
Is this the guy?
Basically this.
I didn't hear him coming at all. He's gotta be the one.
Yeah.
But look at him.
He's ancient. Up. That's rude. Yep, ancient my ass, bitch. Take that. CQC, motherfucker. Ooh, nice. it's stabbing my disc from 4. Absolutely. I mean, it's difficult, I'll give it that. Well, I mean, difficulty is always good and bad, right? If done properly, it can be a lot of fun. But if it's just difficult for the sake of being difficult, that usually takes the fun away. CQC, Snake.
No doubt about it. He is the legendary soldier. Call me Mama.
Big Mama.
My, how you've grown, David.
David.
It was you, not I, who was created from the rib of man.
Does the game seem a little quiet to you guys? It seems quite quiet to me. Let me just turn it up a bit. Mother.
What?
She's our mother.
Les enfants terribles. You can't grow a human being in a test tube, not even a clone. You need a woman's body to give it life.
You mean a surrogate mother?
That's an awful way to put it. I am your mother.
Oh, I did turn it up a bit. Let me know if that's better in any way. I meant to turn it up more. I feel like the game itself is just good quieter since the last time we played.
Birth.
The forbidden fruit. Appropriate. No? Follow me. I'll explain everything.
All right. Seems better. Okay, good. I'll go just a little bit higher.
The man who wants me dead is Liquid, your twin. You think you know him, but I know him better.
That's not how the song goes.
He was once Ocelot, but Liquid has taken control of his soul. And now he's locked in a bitter struggle with Zero.
Zero?
The founder of the Patriots.
Founder?
Oh shit.
When did this happen?
40 years ago. During the Cold War, when the United States and the Soviet Union were still at odds. It was in that chaotic era that the Patriots were born. And I played my part. I was one of the founding members.
So how old is she?
You.
Zero created the Patriots to...
I mean, I suppose she could be in her 50s or 60s.
That control endured long after the Cold War ended. The organization became an empty shell, continuing to function through AIs.
AI.
Those AIs are responsible for the creation of the war economy, and they gave rise to the Sons of the Patriot system. But I am partly to blame. I bear some of the guilt for creating the organization. It was right after I first met your father, Big Boss.
It's interesting to hear them refer to them as mother and father, right?
I was ordered to take part in a CIA op called Operation Snake Eater, which concerned a new weapon the Soviets were developing at the time. My mission was to support a certain agent.
Oh shit, that's her?
Later became Big Boss, but I knew him as Snake.
Snake?
Yes.
Dude!
Naked Snake. That was his code name at the time. A name he would give to you.
That is so cool.
The commander of this mission was a man called Zero, the head of Special Forces Unit Fox. Back then, I was working as a double agent for the Chinese. My objective was to secure the location of the philosopher's legacy, a massive cache of hidden wealth, and report it to Beijing. I was to
that is so cool, dude.
A microfilm showing the location of
this blew my mind a little bit.
Funds amassed by the Allied powers during World War II. But I failed in my mission and was expelled from China. I took the apple from the snake and was cast
augmented. Don't even get me started right now.
I ended up in Hanoi. That's where I met him again. It was around then that Zero used the massive funds contained in the Philosopher's Legacy to start a new organization, the Patriots, which would carry out the final wishes of a certain legendary hero. The initial membership consisted of Big Boss, Sigint, Paramedic, and their commander, Zero. Oh, and
okay.
There was one more who we mustn't forget. He stayed behind in the Soviet Union to support the group as an informant. Ocelot. Who is now liquid. After your father rescued me in Hanoi, I went to America and joined their organization. Zero's goal was to achieve a unity of thought and awareness. He believed that was what the boss wanted, and the rest of the Patriots followed his lead.
The boss?
The boss was a legendary hero from the Second World War, known as the Mother of Special Forces. She had an almost overwhelming charisma about her. The CIA feared this, so they had her eliminated. If she had survived, the world of the 21st century might have been a very different place. We were all influenced by the boss's will. It was what drove us to create this organization, to be closer to that spirit. Zero decided that in order to lead the people, we needed a special kind of icon. So he turned to Big Boss, the last son of the boss. He shared more of her life than anyone else. It was Big Boss, the true heir to her legacy, who was best suited to play this role.
That is so cool. I really enjoy, out of anything else, I really enjoy the fact that this game is just bringing it all together.
The status of an idol. The truth behind Big Boss
it's very satisfying.
Exaggeration, misrepresentation, and outright lies. Zero disseminated these stories among the masses and gathered the rich and powerful to his banner. Every era needs its symbols to control the people. Whether it be the stars and stripes, or the hammer and sickle. As the times and currents of politics changed, so too did Zero. Eventually, he became a prisoner of his own lust for power, sparking friction between him and Big Boss, who resented playing the puppet. With Big Boss drifting away, Zero realized he would need insurance.
Something going to be
that
more.
Would perpetuate the existence of Big Boss, their organization's icon. And so Zero.
I mean, it sure seems like they're just trying to bring it all home, right?
Les Enfants.
And like, it is advertised as the last adventure for Snake.
The clone of Big Boss,
so I can definitely see that.
Ultimate soldier. The project was led by Dr. Clark, known at the time as Paramedic. After dozens of failures, they finally, miraculously, succeeded in producing a fertilized egg. The egg used in the successful in vitro fertilization came from Dr. Clark's assistant, a healthy Japanese woman.
Blood from the East flows within your veins.
Give birth to Big Boss. To realize this, I asked to serve as a surrogate mother and was more than happy to carry you in my womb. I loved him. 9 months later, I gave birth to two Big Bosses, you and Liquid.
How adorable.
It didn't matter that you were clones or that they had manipulated your DNA. You were born the same way as any other normal child, from your mother's womb. But Les Enfants Terribles proved to be the final straw for Zero and Big Boss. Determined to oppose Zero and his plans, Big Boss broke away from the Patriots. He left the States,
and they each took a kid.
Created his own mercenary company, and drifted around the world.
No worries, Perch. Go for it, buddy. We still got about an hour left in stream anyway, so.
Never wanted you. Human life isn't meant to be manipulated like that. I knew that, but I wanted you. After Big Boss left, Zero really lost control. What Zero wanted was an orderly world, one governed by rules. His fortune grew through countless wars, and his words influenced decision-making all the way up to the Oval Office. As the world saw the rise of digital technology, IT, the internet, and genetics, the Patriots' power grew immense. Their roots spread and took hold throughout the globe. In time, they began to dictate the fate of entire nations from the shadows. And before we knew it,
I really just became a dictator of the world.
The proud police of the world started bringing an entire planet under their control.
I mean, that is quite an accomplishment, I'll give him that. But just to hell with freedom at that point, right?
Ooh. Their intentions were fair, but their execution was flawed. Zero developed weapons, amassed armies, used information for extortion, all in order to gain more wealth. He was obsessed with controlling awareness on the inside from the outside. But I cannot imagine that's what the boss would have wanted. They both misinterpreted her will. And their absolute reverence for her drove them apart. So began the war between Zero and Big Boss. Opposing interpretations, each striving to realize the boss's will. Everything you see today stems from their cold war. Differences in race, in religion, in ideology.
So deep.
This war they've caused is no different from any other human error in history.
That's some cool artwork.
It all started with a tiny fork in the path. And grew into a great rift. There was nothing left of the boss's noble will in their struggle. All that remained was hatred, a passion to destroy one another. Big Boss returned to the U.S. with a plan in mind. And once again assumed command of Foxhound. In Outer Heaven, and then Zanzibar Land, Big Boss plotted coup d'etat against Zero. But you, Solid Snake, his own clone, foiled his efforts both times. Big Boss and Gray Fox...
Oh, so those must have been on the older games that
were
we...
...were left near death. Zero recovered their bodies.
That's
Frank
interesting.
Frank Yeager's entire body was reconstructed through surgery. And he was reborn as the cyborg ninja. Big Boss, now a vegetable, became a prisoner of Zero even in death. For Zero, more than anyone else, your father was an irreplaceable icon. No, the truth is, for Zero, he was an irreplaceable friend. After Big Boss's betrayal, Zero could no longer believe in something so uncertain as life. He lost his belief in everything. Nations, organizations, individuals. Zero was no longer willing to place his organization in the hands of the next generation. Instead, he set up a network of AIs, a decision-making system formed from all the information he had accumulated. He built four AIs, GW, TJ, AL, and TR, as sort of a digital Mount Rushmore. And one core artificial intelligence to unite them, John Doe.
Just all you. Metal Gear Solid, or Metal Solid, 5 years ago. Games using the MGS5 engine. Ever since GW, I would play that. I mean, I've never actually played any of those games before. To be honest, I didn't even know they existed.
Economics, politics, law, morals.
So you know, I'm sure I'm missing out a chunk of stuff at the time.
In the shadow,
all the memes and nano machines. Hey, Nasazi, how's it going, dude? World,
Big Boss isn't allowed to live.
How are you doing, buddy? Nice to see you.
He's trapped for eternity in a brain dead prison. To bind himself to his friend, to ensure his rule over the world, Zero transformed Big Boss into an icon, neither living nor dead.
Sounds almost like a religion.
Naturally, Ocelot and I planned to free him from Zero's prison.
Planned?
We enlisted Naomi Hunter, an authority in the field of nanomachine research, into our organization.
Okay.
And we used Frank Yeager to kill Dr. Clark. Ocelot tortured the DARPA chief, Donald Anderson.
How you doing, man? I'm doing well.
Also known as Signet, to death, and made it look like an accident.
Really getting my getting like my mind blown by all the
with paramedic
like
Signet,
intertwining of all the games here and the explanation being given.
But we too paid the price. I lost Ocelot. Ocelot wasn't fighting for the Pentagon or the Russians, and certainly not for Zero. He was fighting for Big Boss. He idolized him.
So it's a bit of a plot twist that, you know, turns out Ocelot was sort of a good guy all these years.
When Ocelot grafted Liquid's right arm to his own, his body was taken over by Liquid's thoughts and spirit. He may be Ocelot in physical form, but his mind is Liquid's.
And all the old sneaky G.
I was the
last.
I
mean, wait, what?
And then someone appeared to help me.
Raiden.
Badass Raiden.
It was when I met him that I finally discovered the location of Big Boss. It was in the data he obtained from GDC.
And after you beat the game, man. Hey, go for it, because I'm sure there's... Like, this seems to be one of those games that, like, you really need to play at least a couple of times to really get the overall, you know, plot and like, all the crossovers here and there. Weather is fantastically crafted.
People need heroes. Zero wanted to create a messiah. A legend that would never die.
Liquid is after Big Boss's body. Is it here?
I'll take you to meet him.
I'm in release order. Kind of have a mixed view on the characters and such. Yeah, kinda, but I mean, I suppose...
This is his pix. His holy ark.
I suppose if you played it in more like actual chronological order, maybe things would make a little bit more sense. But even so... Like, I do really like the fact that they're all coming together. Whoa. Oh, shit!
His body is alive, but his consciousness is locked away by nanomachines.
That is... something else.
So technically speaking, he's not really brain dead.
Crunch,
we can't allow Liquid to inherit the same sins that corrupted Zero. Manipulating people's minds for the sake of his own ego.
Dude, that's a little disturbing to look at. I don't know that we can answer right now.
Otacon.
Snake, it's Naomi.
What happened?
She's gone. She's not in the Nomad anymore.
When?
Less than an hour ago. She disappeared right after she and Sunny got back from Dr. Madden's
Sunny!
Place.
Why weren't you watching her?
I didn't have my glasses on.
Really?
She said it herself. The experiment can't succeed without her.
You think she went back to Liquid?
What about Raiden?
good news on that front.
What
we managed to
is
get our
that?
Hands on a dialysis machine.
What is that?
We just started him on dialysis and treatment for his wounds.
Will he live?
Yeah, no worries there. Sonny's taken over for Naomi. But his treatment's probably going to take 48 hours.
What the?
Until then, Raiden can't...
What is that? Is that Otacon?
Hey, come here!
What the hell are these?
Move!
Those are terrifying. Enhance. Yeah, I know who she is. You don't need to give me the memory.
Scarabs. Unmanned scouts.
They found us.
Found you. Dude, those are terrifying. I do not want to come across this thing.
The PMCs are converging on your location. Damn it! They're sending in Gecko!
Oh, shit.
In less than 5 minutes.
Are they ready?
Yes, ma'am.
We'll escape through the canal route using the real van. Get it ready. Hurry.
Yes, ma'am.
Snake, over here.
Over here?
You've got decoy
vans. Okay, get a little bit more of that.
Sewers away.
Nice. The bike lives. Where's the side cart though?
All of these children were orphans. They work in arms factories. And when they grow up, they want to join a PMC. They seek revenge on other companies, PMCs that killed their parents, and use their earnings to support their younger siblings. There are countless child soldiers like these in the PMCs. Huh. Nowadays, anyone with a computer can get combat training. The FPS games that these children love are distributed for free by these companies.
FPS games, really?
Of course, it's all just virtual training. It's so easy for them to
Bark,
get
the cows, cows can move.
And before they know it,
goes move. Wait, what? Yeah, I noticed that at first. So I was like, why are we moving?
They're fighting in proxy wars that have nothing to do with their own lives. They think it's cool to fight like this. They think that combat is life.
Hashtag
they
combat
don't
is life.
They need a reason to fight. After all, for them, it's only a game. Zero is the cause of all this. Defeating Liquid won't change things.
Oh, really?
Unless we stop the Patriot system, the cycle will
I
go
do not. I must have missed that in there right now. Yeah,
hang on. Hop on.
Oh, here we go again.
Hold on to me.
All right, let's do this.
With so many wars being waged, oil and biofuel have become as precious as diamonds. It's been a while since I went out for a ride.
Are you sure about this?
I only get off my bike when I fall in love.
Okay.
Or fall dead.
Big Mama.
Okay, don't ever say her name
Call
like that.
Call me Eva.
I was way too sensual for a mother saying Big Mom. Like the pretty sweet bike. Sexual with OG. I know, right? And it's weird. This is Mom.
Here we go.
Hit it. The physics-defying motorbike. Radiate with L1, fire it with R1, equip with a laser sight while aiming to use the iron sight to switch between semi-auto and full auto. Alright. I don't know if we need it. I'm assuming we're gonna have to shoot out some people while we're on the bike. I'm probably not gonna use the Uzi for it. But
we have to keep Big Boss's body out of enemy hands, no matter what. Get the body safely to the canal escape.
Oi! Just like that, huh? No. You give me a real gun right now. Wait, that's the only thing I can use, goddammit. Yeah. Oh, that guy literally disappeared. Okay, good. This is a good driver. We need that one. Get him. What the crusade we got going on, though? Right, Casey?
Yeah.
Cinematic views are fantastic.
There's another one! Get ourselves behind that checkpoint. Ready? Ooh. Hold on!
Okay. Yeah, Big Mama. Nope. Nice. I'm trying. This thing holds like 3 bullets. There we go. That went through.
On the right.
Oh no. Apparently just kills them all in one hit. That's most powerful gun in the game, apparently. Oh shit.
There you are, Snake! Where's your anger? Show me your rage!
That's the win. Grenade. so those are drones, and there's only like one actual Raven. That's good, I think. I hope.
More incoming!
I've got bad news. The decoy vans have all bitten the dust, which means the enemy will be focusing on you now. I just need you to hold them off a little longer.
Excellent, Snake! Have you tried aiming the gas?
Shut up!
Have you tried aiming the gun? So rude. This is like the most powerful gun in the entire series.
Enemy, get ahead!
Woo!
Nice one!
Oh, dude, I'm getting all the revenues. Yeah, oh my god. Did you say that's my point? That guy died as quick as it came out. Alright, tire. Tell me this is I really thought maybe I could buy some like a trophy related to you. Very people like to have these things. But it's the first one. I can't.
I think we lost them.
Alright. That went about as well as it could have been. Oh. big boss is not gonna be very much alive anymore.
Are you okay?
Unless everything is bolted to the ground in that van, that took a tumble.
Big Mama, come on. Stay with me.
Oh, dude.
Eva, I need you.
Is that you?
No. Well, yes. No.
Mother's work is never done.
Big Mama.
I don't know what I'm looking at there. But damn.
Where's the van?
Yeah. There's probably not much of a van left. Go! Yeah.
Children.
There is no way anything is alive in there. Not a chance. Yeah. Hey, Purge. Welcome back, buddy.
No.
Snake's like, oh, I'm gonna kill me a bird right now.
She'll be coming to search the van.
I'll take care of it. You stay here. Keep watch.
I'll contact the children.
Here. Take this.
Snake.
Saying hi to everybody.
Come back in
awesome.
Peace.
I will.
Promise me.
Promise. Oh, nice. He actually has the M4 on. Okay, yeah, that's too many guns you're holding now, Snake. You gotta stick with one, buddy. I suspect this to be a little tough. Flying bosses are never really that straightforward. I really thought that was the ceiling, the roof already. Snake, not now, buddy. Not now. Get the EpiPen. There you go, boy. There you go, buddy. We'll get another prescription going, and we'll fill that shit up, and you'll be fine. Settling. he's gonna fly through the fucking building like that. That's totally fair. We even kill those ones? I'm assuming we must be able to. Oh, wait. Do not waste the suppressor when it is not needed. Dude, I might throw in the MK there instead. A little spray of protection. Cool. Oh! Okay. Cool. No, okay. Alright. Alright, stay inside. Take what? I don't want it. Oh, nice! Homes hit on enemies? We do, yeah. Equip though. But hold on, that might be a decent choice right now. I don't know if I'll be able to use it properly though. Have a tank, grenade launcher, mini barrel. Could have sworn we did. This might be it, but I think. Rocket launcher developed to give entry a light, easy to use method accompanying tanks. Makes it too weak to stand up on today's MBTs, but it's sufficient power to deal with light armor vehicles and soft skin targets. It's a high power grenade launcher, even 50 years after its debut, blah blah blah. Don't really care. Huh. I really thought we did. Unless it's locked. You know what? It may be locked. You know, I don't think we have it yet. We're doing like no damage to her though. Switch guns for a second. Maybe here.
Something's coming! Get out of there, Snake!
Okay, well. Too late, because I'm on the wrong side of the things.
Cool down!
you cool down while I shoot down your little. I don't know if I'm meant to like find her while she's trying to. We've been already to the floor. Is that her or is that a drone? That's a drone. That shit. Oh, that's actually her. I didn't know if jumping through there was gonna work. What? She's just gonna stand there and let me shoot her. That is fine by me. I liked it a little bit more when she met us inside. This is going a little bit too smooth for my liking. And that's not me doing some sort of humble brag bullshit. It's an actual legitimate concern. There you are. Okay, hello. Don't do that. Get out. I'm very happy I was not around for that. Alright. missing out on like a golden opportunity right now, but I have no idea where she is. So we're on our own now. Well, yes and no. We still get the regain. But we'll give a little bit of help, but not too much. She's taking a very minuscule amount of health. Nope. Nice. She's taking a very minuscule amount of health every time, though. Disbelief that that's going to be the end of that fight. Like I said, it seemed a little too simple. They really went all out with the like, disturbing scenes after these boss fights.
Let me out of this cage. I don't need these wings. I don't need this range.
Snakes, like, get the fuck away from me, lady. Alright, well, as with,
Snake! She's come out of her suit! Watch out! She's gonna try to grab you!
Hold up. I was gonna say, as with, Octopus. Gonna try to stick to the non-lethal stuff. Leg dodges every second hit. Tell the truth. This like background grunting and stuff is kind of freaking me out. Oh, we got her. Not dead yet, but I have a feeling. Yeah, she's sort of reverting to that fetal position state, that optimal state. Raging Raven. That's so sad, though. Oh, cool. We got a grenade launcher out of it. This are all so fucking tragic, man.
Draven.
Ooh, Draven. Hello.
And you got yourself a souvenir, too. A grenade launcher. Nice. That's a real user-friendly weapon.
Not much use to me without an ID, though.
I laundered this one free of charge.
Well, thanks.
What's the catch?
Only that you give it to me when you're done with it. A weapon with that many decades of rage stored up inside it? Now that's a collector's item.
How old was she?
I'd say about 20. But she had years of soldier's rage hidden away in that youthful body of hers.
Soldiers?
Yeah, the soldiers of Ake. A place that hasn't seen peace in a long, long time. She was captured by one side or another, and kept caged up like an animal, along with God knows how many other kids.
Anonymous violence.
Exactly. It's unknown whether her captors were with the government or the rebels. In any case, they got their kicks by abusing these helpless little kids day after day after day. That constant barrage, that battlefield rage slowly built up inside their bodies, their minds. The kids tried to keep each other's spirits up, always clinging to the hope that someone would come to their rescue, barely surviving off of scraps of food. But those soldiers didn't stop. They called the kids parasites and shit-eating ravens, beat them even harder. Then one morning, the soldiers just up and left, leaving the surviving kids to be eaten alive by the birds. Almost like one of those sky burials.
Jesus.
One by one, their bodies were picked apart by ravens' beaks, until finally the flock came for her. But by some miracle, their beaks cut her bonds instead. And like that, she was liberated. In that instant, she was filled with an uncontrollable rage, and it smothered her soul. She ripped the ravens pecking at her to pieces, and then went after the soldiers. And when she finally caught up with them, she waited until nightfall like a hunter awaiting its prey. They say that when a raven cries, a man dies. And that's exactly what happened that night. Screeching and cawing, she killed every last living being in the camp. Both the soldiers and the civilians they'd enslaved.
Well,
in her eyes, there was no longer a difference. The cruelty her friends had suffered, The pain and humiliation she'd endured. Hers was the distillation of the rage that decades of war had imparted on those soldiers.
I was wondering that too, Ragnar.
And her greatest weakness.
You're something else, Snake. You managed to cleanse Raven of her rage. No, seriously. You're the seed of war.
Fucking dragon. I mean, sure, but also, like, how does he have all the...
Maybe it's still too early to tell. You've still got half the B&B Corps ahead of you. Keep your eye on the ball, pal.
Six sugar grenade launcher is 40 minutes. Yeah, I mean... Skullhead uses the same kind of technology as Octo Camo, shaped to resemble Raging Beauty's face. Well, I don't know if that's going to really come in handy in any way, but sure. Probably not going to use a grenade launcher, to be honest. I'm not much of a grenade launcher noob tuber myself. It's too messy.
Snake. I have to apologize. The three vans that came out with us are decoys.
Anyone that's connected to the network with the nanomachines, of course, there's going to be profiles on everyone in the network somewhere. I'm sure Trevor has access to those files.
I managed to get in touch with the children.
I guess, yeah, that does make sense.
Is safe. We're going to rendezvous on the riverbank, downstream.
When you put it that way, Land and actually use logic, then, off.
But there's you really justify the guy. The Volta River is our only chance.
Nanomachines. Nanomachines.
Oh, let's get out of here. Hurry.
Good thinking.
All right. Just said nanomachines. Yeah, well, all you need is just nanomachines. You don't need to go any further than that. Into the sewers.
This way. Follow me.
But the bike. It's done.
I don't need to feel the wind anymore. There's no need to keep lying to myself.
What do you mean?
I only get off my bike when I fall in love. Or...
Oh, wait, there was some... I think I missed the memories there.
Give me a hand.
Yeah.
You've got to, like, patch her up in some way.
The underground aqueduct leads to the river. There should be fewer of them down there.
Oh. I don't know... I don't want to deal with these little abominations. I'm gonna have nightmares. Nanomachines plus what sort of all-knowing, all-controlling being such as the Patriots wouldn't keep tabs on every single person and their background somewhere within the GW system. It's only logical. I agree with you. Don't worry. It does make a lot of sense, if not actually all of the sense. I really thought this would be the end of the chapter, but apparently not. Or not yet, at least. I guess we just started this chapter too. I just figured once we actually kill Raven, that would be the, or like, well, every time that we kill, Liquid. But yeah, I figured every time we kill one of those, the main bosses there, we're moving on to the next.
Liquid.
Where's the pigs?
That no longer matters.
Where is it?
Oh, shit!
Is that it?
Well, there it went. Naomi
told me everything. And now, thanks to her, I finally have it. The thing I've sought for so long. Big Boss. Put down the gun, Snake. It's already too late.
Hate Naomi so much.
You almost.
I thought she was good!
But it looks like I win after all.
Seems to just keep backstabbing everybody.
Cigars. Father's favorite. What do you say? Care for one last smoke? Huh. You think you're Big Boss now?
Uh-huh. Getting her MGS1 will always hit her.
Guilty as charged.
That's just her personality trait. It's just backstabber.
But all that ends today.
Almost be a traitor, yeah. Ah, rude. Oh, CQC, buddy. Let's go. Oh, shit. God damn. This guy had no joke.
Nice try. But when it comes to CQC, I've got the upper hand.
And how's that exactly? Casey, don't try
to. Even if you do get a hold of the system, you'll only have one part of the Patriots AI. The military part.
Oh shit. Okay.
It's only a matter of time before I have everything.
How did that happen?
Remember GW? The AI they think they lost? It's mine. A part of my army.
Impossible. We destroyed it.
Or at least I thought we did. Stun knife. Oh, okay, that's what it is then.
We only managed to cut GW into little pieces. Pieces we were able to reconstruct. And then we stowed it away inside JD's network. This man's body has served me well, allowing me to pass every security barrier between me and GW.
There goes the entirety of MGS2 right there.
The Patriot system is nothing more than a machine. Now that GW is a spook inside the network, there's no way JD would recognize it as an external threat. Once I destroy JD with a nuclear strike, the Patriot's network will be mine. And then, I'll build my haven, free from all forms of control. I'll cast aside my old identity, and take my own name for the first time.
Seems solid.
Liquid, you're planning to recreate the Patriots.
Snake, we were created by the Patriots. We're not men. Shadows in the shape of men.
The monologuing. What it's all about.
We're freaks who never should have existed. We're a
future generations never prosper.
Dude, just pull that shit out.
The Patriots saw fit to create us, and in doing so became our only raison d'etre. I won't fight my fate any longer. I'll kill Zero and Big Boss and become a patriot myself. It all began with Zero and Big Boss. Our purpose in life is to fulfill our destinies. And once all is returned to Zero, the world can be reborn.
Is he gonna kill me right now? Well, that's some BDSM shit right there.
Know an age of light. If we're to pass the baton to the next generation, the only choice left to us is death.
Boss.
Good. The players have all assembled, Snake. The time has come for you to witness. Witness our moment of triumph.
Oh, what's happening now?
Go!
Oh, this is gonna leave him there to die. Let's see. Hey, homie, you bitch. Tragedies upon tragedies here. Oh shit, it's them! It's the Johnny Patrol! There he is. Liquid's like, nah, we'll just keep going.
Drop your weapons and stand down, now!
I don't know what Vamp is so worried about, he's just... quote-unquote immortal. About it, rocking those car lines. That is a lot of military force. Now that the boat is actually a Metal Gear, they're just gonna all of a sudden stand up and fly out of the water.
Fuck.
this is gonna fail in some amazing fashion. That's a lot of people who are very likely going to die. I love all the time they're taking to show the preparation. Like, yeah, we get it. There's a lot of bloody people aiming their guns at these at the boat. The buildup is unnecessarily long here.
All of you, drop your weapons and put your hands up!
That's not quite what you meant.
Meryl!
Why does he have a name tag? I never noticed that.
Aim!
Liquid! Stop!
What does that mean? Suspense is actually killing me.
Huh?
Wait, what? He just somehow broke everybody's gun? Because of the IDs. He shut down their IDs, didn't he? Nobody can use the weapon. Holy shit, that is... a gigantic loophole, but also incredibly smart. Oh, here we go.
The system is mine. Your guns and your weapons are no longer your own.
That is so terrifying. And he can do that.
Behold! Guns of the Patriots! Bang! Bang!
Wait, he could kill the helicopters too? Oh shit. Oh. Well, I was about to say, at least they landed on the water. Apparently, they're the ones who blow up.
Die!
Johnny! Johnny, no! Somebody told me why he's not affected by this. He totally has a thing for Meryl.
Let them have it. We don't need it anymore.
Need what? Oh. In the fire. This is too much. Wearing sunglasses in the night like a fucking douchebag that you are. Jesus. That was a lot of death at once. On the fields.
Meryl. Meryl.
The second time Meryl's gonna die. Oh shit, that's what Johnny looks like. Pop her chest, you don't just blow air into her mouth. Yeah, there you go, buddy. Oh, come on, bud, you got this. You got this, buddy.
Give up on me.
Come on. Come on.
Meryl.
God damn
Don't
it.
Go. Meryl.
Oh, shit. She's up. Nice. Woo.
Meryl. Meryl. It's not, I mean.
Aww.
Thank you.
Okay, Meryl.
Okay. One small bottle, one here. I'm okay with that. Damn,
it's all right.
So dreamy.
Call me Johnny.
Johnny over here being a fucking heartbreaker.
You and the beasts are no different. Scorched shadows born to the world. When a beast steps into the light...
The controller has shut off at this point.
Unless the light is put out, the shadow...
Oh shit, I think the controller is dead now. Oh.
So long as there is light, there is shadow. To return everything to normal. The light must be extinguished. And when that happens, you will be too...
she knows. Burnt out face over here.
Like I said, we pride ourselves on service.
Hey. There we go, finally.
Come on, let's take this guy to his friends.
It's a lot of dead bodies right there. That's the end of that, but I don't have a controller to continue on with, so just give me one sec, guys. I'll go grab one. Ooh, trophy. Nice. How you doing, buddy? 58,000 Dragon points. I should probably do something with those. There we go. New mic? No. It's been the same mic all along. It might be a little bit louder than usual, if you think that you're hearing me a little bit clearer. Or it could just be my voice, because I'm still sick. But damn, dude, that was a lot of tragedy at once. Super quiet in there. Oh, I was sort of coming back and grabbing this thing. Mission briefing. Okay, well, you know what, guys? We're gonna call it right now. Obviously, we went already about a half hour after, just because of the scenes, and this is exactly why I make these. Well, I mean, we'll see it afterwards if it comes to it. This is exactly why I only schedule this game when. Okay, well, I'm just gonna go ahead and shut it off. Why I only schedule this game when I have a little bit more time afterwards, but anyways, guys, as I mentioned, that is gonna do it for now. So let's go ahead and come on over here, throw a little bit of music on as always, and I'll say thank you very much, everybody, for coming by and watching. I hope you all enjoyed. Let me just go ahead and turn this down a little bit, getting back to normal volume there. That was a lot happened in that chapter there. That was very shocking. I mean, there was a lot of like plot development and things like that, right, where they actually explain to you exactly what's going on in the game, how everything's connected and things like that. They sort of tied it all nicely in a neat little bow there, but that last like half hour scene was definitely something else there with you know, Liquid really actually showing off the kind of power they actually has over the entire world basically at this point, and it's pretty scary. I don't know how we're gonna deal with that in the end. It'd be interesting to see how actually this will develop towards the end, but yeah, it's creepy, and to think that something like that could essentially happen in a future at some point, right? But I guess that's sort of where one of the things that this game or this series does is to sort of show you where things could end up once if not developed properly. But and as well, as for now, hope everybody enjoyed. If you haven't already, go ahead and click that follow button. We'd very much appreciate it. And of course, we'd love to see you guys back in the future. No more scheduled streams at this point, just because it was just a very short week. I'm thinking maybe we'll probably make up something on Sunday. I don't know yet. what or when, but I will let you guys know on Discord and on Twitter when that happens. Have a good one there, Ragna. And but until then, hope everybody has a fantastic rest of your day and or evening, and I will see you all next time. Bye-bye. Control.